goes to none but me.
Ooh. you're going up to the Wicklow song for me.
So. Hey, man. I've got everyone out of
it.
Shocking me all again. Shocking all again.
What time did you ride last night? After dawn?
About, it was near 1 o'clock.
The stroke would be. Where did the lift went in Dungannon?
Craig Alvin.
You go down there and get a marine, you know, it's a long way to run. I was out there today.
Were you out today?
I did
two
of them.
It's very sad, isn't it?
Ach, my gosh, this is just...
I suppose they'll cover up like everything else.
Did you hear McGinnis say this morning?
An accidental shoot.
I don't know what was stuck with him, the big hit up.
Were you listening to them days during the year?
Oh, too many lays in this one. I come to God, it's
cold, mate.
It's got cold. It's going to get cold, Raymond.
Snow maybe forecast. You got up for me? You from bed again?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. by your precious blood, come we implore you to our aid. Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Have mercy on us, O Lord, have mercy. May your mercy always be with us, O Lord, and we are hope in you. May Christ be sanctified for your sake, be your pardon. May Christ be guided for you, and may you come eternal life. May Christ, the Son of the God, send you out of the experience of our life. Thank you. your call from this life. Bless me with the trusting of your sins in your kingdom of light and peace. We ask this through Jesus Christ.
Righteous man shall be thy first time. saw did not spare his own son, but gave him up to benefit us all. We may be certain, after such a gift, that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God acquits, could anyone condemn? Good question, Jesus. No, he only died for us. He rose from the dead, and there at God's right hand, he stands on the place for us. Nothing, therefore, can come between us and God. Even if we are troubled or worried, or being persecuted, or lacking food or clothes, or being threatened, or even attacked, these are the trials through which we triumph, by the power of him who loved us. For I am certain of this, neither death nor life, no angel, no prince, nothing that exists, nothing still to come, not any power or height or depth, nor any created thing, will ever come between us and the love of God, made visible in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of God.
That is our consolation today at this sad time for us.
his faith and his hope and his trust in him was dead. So today in this Mass we pray for him. We pray that the Lord would have mercy on his soul and that the Lord would grant him eternal rest, that he may live forever in his presence in heaven. Dear people, this is a very sad day for us in our community. We are attending the funeral of a young man that's 24 years old, taken from amongst us in the prime of his life. The circumstances of his death were tragic. Sunday was a black day for us in Auchmuty. On the way to a local football match, Aiden was shot in the back of the lead by the security forces for no apparent reason. He died almost instantly. We, all of us here, condemn absolutely this callous killing. It is hard to believe that such a thing is possible on a Sunday afternoon in broad daylight. So all of us here, we feel threatened. We feel we cannot walk the roads in safety. All of us here, we feel threatened by constant harassment and suspicion. We all of us here feel threatened because we are unable to live our lives with dignity and peace and respect, free from fear. To allay our fears, I think we can and should demand a thorough and public investigation of the circumstances of this shooting, and to be assured that such a thing would never happen again. We may feel shocked and angered or sad or even bitter, and have experienced all these emotions in the community over the last few days. But we are a Christian community, and as a Christian community, gathered around this altar to offer the sacrifice of the Mass, we must cast out all bitterness, hatred, or thoughts of revenge from our minds and from our hearts. We want no reprisals for Abel's death. In this Mass, we pray for those who killed him and their superiors. But we want in our community here in Auchmuty, is it to be a community of reconciliation, of love, and of forgiveness? And this morning we pray also that this reconciliation may be possible. And this morning we pledge ourselves to work toward this reconciliation and hope to see it one day. To help us in this process, nevertheless, I think we have legitimate demands, and I want to articulate them on behalf of our community here in Auchmuty. The Church teaches respect for human life. Human life is sacred. We must respect life at all times. The teaching of the Church abhors killing of all and every kind. And we believe that in this case, human life was not respected. We believe that in too many cases, legally held guns were not used with proper control and discipline. And we also believe
who get killed in this way are not punished and are not amenable to the law. And that is why we are afraid. We are surrounded by so many legally held bodies that we demand a proper control and discipline for them. And we demand that those who misuse them should be punished accordingly. Also, over the last few days, we've heard so many times, we believe that there's too much harassment of our people at the checkpoint in our town. We've heard this over and over again. In my short time here with you, I have heard it. You know, over the last few days of this particular incident, complaints have also been made to my predecessor here and to many other concerned police and other concerned people. We're told that young people going about their daily work are harassed as they pass the checkpoint. They are insulted and abused, they are bullied, they are treated with bad manners, and they are delayed deliberately an indecent amount of time. This is a permanent well-equipped post. There's no need for this delay or for this harassment. I suspect that our young people are treated in this way because they are Catholics and because they have nationalist aspirations. So we demand that such ill treatment should immediately stop before we have another similar tragedy. We also demand that the life and civil liberty of us all shown the respect it deserves. On behalf of us all here this morning, dear people, I want to offer our sympathy to Aiden's family. I want to offer our sympathy to father and mother, John and Lizzie, to his sisters, Aiden and Margaret, to his brothers, Sean and Jared and Vincent, and their families, and their many relatives and friends. The McAnespie family, a very close-knit family, loving and supportive of each other. Aiden was the youngest of the family, helping at home. He wasn't involved in any paramilitary organization, or was he a member of any political party. He was a fine young man. He was very good to his family, and especially to his parents. He was a very hard worker, traveling some distance to find that work and to carry out his work well. His one hobby and his one great interest in life was sport. And he's highly regarded by everybody in our local team and by everybody in our community, as also is his family. We would all miss him very much in our community as his family would. Very much. It is indeed today a tragedy for us all. This morning, we gather together around the altar to pray for the Lord's heart to be generous. We pray especially for his family, that God will bless them and help them and give them special graces to help us to bear this heavy cross. We commend them to the protection and the intercession of our Lady. Mother of God, we really understand deep sorrow and understand their sorrow and deserve to have them and consider them. We pray that today will be strengthened by our prayers and by our support and by our presence and by our concern and by our care. Let us kneel down now and say a prayer for our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. loved God of all creation, to witness here this wine to offer, through the divine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask for mercy and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Let us pray. Up for you. offer to God the glory and majesty, his holy and perfect sacrifice, the bread of life, and the cup of eternal salvation. Look with favor on these offerings, and accept them as once you accepted the gifts of your servant David, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the bread and wine offered by your priest Melchizedek. Almighty God, we pray that your angel may take this sacrifice to your altar in heaven, and if we receive from this altar the sacred body and blood of your Son, let us be filled with heavenly grace and blessing. Remember, Lord, those who have died, and have gone before us marked with the sign of faith, especially those for whom we now pray. May these and all who sleep in Christ find in your presence life, happiness, and peace. For ourselves too, we ask some share in the fellowship of your apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all the saints. Though we are sinners, we trust in your mercy and love. Do not consider what we fully deserve, but grant us your forgiveness. Through Christ our Lord, you give us all these gifts. You fill them with life and goodness. You bless them and make them holy. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Let us pray with confidence in God, in the words of Savior and our Father.
Yes. Thank you.
Aiden McAnespie.
people of God, as you know very well, I have never hesitated to condemn forthrightly all killings carried out by paramilitary groups. And when appropriate, I have never hesitated to call them murder, even when sometimes deaths were accidental. And therefore, in view of this, how can I now
yard. ABC.
Have eternal rest. Thank you. Found it.
You have your own trial. Go back. some ricochet.
Thank you.
told you, eh? trust in my God since the start of my life. When can I enter and see the face of God? Lord, redeem your people by your precious blood. Come your throne, your poor aid. Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. May mercy also get to death. May Christ, Son, the living God, set you down the fresh beauty of his paradise. And may he, the good shepherd, gain you one of his flock, and give you all your sins. May bless you with this upon the elect, known by hand.
Let us pray, Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And even though the bodies lie on the earth, they trust that they elect you will rise again. Give our brother peaceful rest in this grave, until that day when you, the resurrection and life, will raise him up in glory to the perfection and the company of the saints. Then may you see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where you live forever and ever. Amen. Since Almighty God has called our brother Aiden from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth from which it was made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. We commend our brother to the Lord. May the Lord receive him into his peace and raise up his body on the last day. Dust you are, and unto dust you shall return, but the Lord will raise you up on the last day. Let us pray for our brother to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith. Lord, hear us.
Our gracious hear
us. You raised the dead to life. Give our brother eternal life. We ask this in faith. Lord, hear us.
Our gracious hear us.
Our brother was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious hear us.
He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious hear us.
Comfort us in our sorrow with the death of our brother. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious hear us.
Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior give us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen. Lord God, you always listen to sincere prayers. You have celebrated the funeral rite of our brother. And now we ask you to grant him a share in that blessed reward which you have prepared for all the saints, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray for the bereaved. O Lord Jesus Christ, God of all consolation, who was moved to tears at the grave of Lazarus, look now with compassion on your servants who are sorely grieved by their loss. Strengthen in their hearts the spirit of faith to accept this cross from your loving hands. Give to their troubled hearts and to the hearts of all men the light of hope. May they so live that one day they may be united again in the kingdom of your love. May the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help those who mourn for Aiden, faith, and by her prayers lead them on to the happiness of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us the powers of hell, and all souls to heaven, especially those most in thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail, O life, the sweetness, and the world hope. To thee do cry, we bind our children of thee. To thee do we send up our sighs, who are weeping in this valley of tears. Thou art the most gracious advocate, and thy mercy towards us. And after is our exile, shown to us the lesser of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, the Holy Mother of God. Let us pray, pour forth to beseech, dear Lord, thy grace into our hearts, as the incarnation of Christ, thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel, made by his passion of cross, and by the glory of his resurrection, the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain all, may the souls of faithfully part, the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Eternal rest grant to him, O Lord. May his soul and the souls of all who faithfully part, the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.